Hi everybody. Just thought we'd have a bit of an assembly because we can't be in the hall at the moment. We can't do the things that we normally do. So I'm doing this here at home and I thought I would show you some artifacts, mainly because we've got a really special date coming up on Friday the 8th of May. As many of you will know, it is the 75th anniversary of VE Day. VE stands for Victory in Europe, and it was effectively the end of the Second World War, although there were still some other battles going around on in other parts of the world. This is a newspaper from the time, and it's one that children and adults would have been very familiar with. It's a huge newspaper. Look at the size of it, full of words and bits, small pieces of writing. No colour photographs in these newspapers, and actually only a couple of pages long, because paper was rationed in those days. It was one of the only ways that people really knew about what was going on in the war. There were the newspapers, there was the radio, and there might be some films at the cinema, but they were very short and they were black and white and not really easy to see what was going on. So, the Second World War had started in September 1939 and it drew to a close in May 1945. For many children, that was 6 years worth of war. Times when their dads had been away, lots and lots of times they'd come home to visit the families for short periods of time and then they'd go away again to battle. So the children lived a life where they saw lots and lots of difficult, they had lots and lots of difficult times, and they saw lots of different things to what we might imagine to see nowadays. I'm wearing a Second World War service dress uniform for the artillery. This uniform is an original Second World War uniform, and it is the type of uniform that a dad may have worn when he was coming home or when he was doing something that wasn't on the battlefield. If once men were fighting, they wore something called battle dress. When they were fighting, they would also have worn one of these as well. This is a steel helmet. It's very heavy, it's very uncomfortable, but it serves a really important purpose, and I know you can guess what that is, because these helmets were to protect the soldiers' heads. And often, when the dads came home, the children would borrow these and they'd play with them outside. Once the war was over, there were a lot of these helmets left and there was nothing to do with them, so the children used them as toys, and they quickly became the focus of games that children played outside. Dad may also have come home with one of these. This is a 303 rifle. It was commonly used in the Second World War. Now this one will never fire another bullet, because it's deactivated, but it was used in the Second World War, and often when dads came home they would have brought these with them, and children would have been used to seeing them. Children would have known that they were not to touch them, because obviously they're very dangerous items. So, by the time the 8th of May came round, 1945, Victory in Europe Day, children's games had changed forever. Children had their teddies, just like you do today. They had their teddies when they were evacuated out of major towns and cities, and many of them weren't living with their parents anymore. Many of them had lost their houses because of the bombing raids, but often they kept their teddies with them. But what they also did was they went on kinds of treasure hunts. So around them there had been lots of bombing raids, there had been lots of aeroplanes that may have been shot down, and often children went looking for remnants or things that were left behind. These kind of things. This is shrapnel, and it is pieces of metal that have come from exploded bombs or aeroplanes that have been shot down. If children found these, they were considered to be really, really important. They loved finding these kind of things, and they kept them as souvenirs. Sometimes, dads would bring home things from the battlefield, and the children would treasure them. They were things that were important to them because they were kind of reminders of what was going on around them. VE Day was going to change their lives drastically. Children had been used to hearing bombing noises, air raid sirens that were really loud noises that made them run to shelters so that they could hide from bombing raids. They'd been used to seeing Spitfires and Lancasters flying overhead and Hurricane fighters. This is an original machine gun from a Spitfire. It was used on an actual Spitfire plane, and children loved to spot the planes in the sky. They could identify Spitfires, Hurricanes, Heinkels, all the different German planes, because they knew what they were looking for and they knew the sounds. Once VE Day came, the skies went silent and the guns stopped and the bombing stopped, and the things that children were used to stopped forever. So it was a time for celebration. It was a time to rejoice that this dreadful time when there'd been all this bombing, this killing, this destruction was coming to an end. And in 1945, the country was extremely patriotic. So the flags that are behind me were really important. This, of course, is the Union Jack. It's our flag, and it's a flag we should be very proud of. This flag here, with the Union Jack in the corner, is the ensign for the Royal Navy. And of course, the Royal Navy fought many, many battles on the sea. This one here, with the roundel, this is the flag for the Royal Air Force. Course, they were responsible for the Battle of Britain, the Spitfires, and all the battles in the air. Children, adults, everybody had been used to shortages. And by 1945, there were shortages in clothing, there were shortages in different food things. You could only have a certain amount of butter, you could only have a couple of eggs. Things were really, really in short rations. And so everybody had ration books. This is a clothing ration book. On the back it's juniors, a junior one, so for a child. There were fuel ration coupons. And this is a ration book that somebody would have used for different things. So they've got coupons for tea, coupons for meat, eggs, and they were removed and exchanged for food that they bought. That didn't stop with the end of the war. And it was a time, even though VE Day came along and the war had finished, it was still a time of shortage. It was still a time to remember people who had died, who were never going to come home again. And it could be, for some people, really quite a sad time. However, the war had finished. Life was going to start to try to return to normal. And people needed to celebrate. Despite the shortages, despite all of the things that they didn't have, they made the best of what they had left, because that was going to be a day where they really celebrated. The end of nearly 6 years of strife, losing loved ones and difficult times. It was a day when everybody really went to town and had a great time. They had parties in the street. They put up bunting. They flew the flag. They were proud to be British. They were proud that they had come through the Second World War and that they had really, really come out the other side, ready to carry on and get on with life. On Friday the 8th of May 2020, it is 75 years since victory in Europe was celebrated. We have been going through some tough times recently, and I know that, and that's why I'm sitting in my front room dressed like this with all these things around me. It's not what I usually do. But I wanted you to think very carefully about all the things that those people have been through. Really difficult times, and in a lot of ways much worse than what we've been going through recently. So on Friday, have a think about this, and with your families, try and do something to remember VE Day. You could have a little party, you could draw some pictures, make a cake, you could do all sorts of things. But whatever you do, can you do me a big favour? Take a photograph, or send me an email, or send me something on Friday to let me know what you've been up to. Our country has a lot to be proud of. It's got to be really proud of the way we're dealing with this situation now, but also the way we've dealt with things in the past. And VE Day is a really good example of that. So take care, everybody, and I will see you soon.